7 says this: one who leads the upright astray in an evil way will himself fall into his own pit. Let me say that again. One who leads the upright astray in an evil way will fall into his own pit, but the blameless will inherit good. The person who is wise in his own eyes, amen, will come to a place of where he stops.
Yes.
But my one God. Who leads away in an evil way, see, that person that mislead and misguided, is trying to direct you off course, trying to get you into the mind of acceptability. That's why, if you notice a lot of things that they try to teach, they try to teach it to these little babies. They try to get them young. See, what they try to do is they try to condition you young. And a lot of things we're seeing that's happening in our communities and our neighborhoods is because their parents or their guardians has conditioned their mindset when they was younger. So now they think this is the only way. They look at the neighborhood they live in, the environment they live in, whether in the inner city, and they look at the environment they live in, and they say, this is the only life we know. Because why? Your mind has already been previously conditioned to think that now I got to be a welfare recipient.
Amen.
My mama was. My grandmama was. And they look at everything they got as living because that's the only thing that they have been exposed to. And anything outside of that, they don't do good in. So they have to go back to the environment. And that's what Satan wants you to do. He do not want you to come out from amongst them and be separated, as the Bible said, but he wants you to stay.
Yes, Lord. All right.
Stay in the hood. Stay in the dark place. Stay in the place that you know everything is going wrong under the sun. He wants you to stay in that environment.
Yes.
I never forget when I moved, I had told myself I started doing good and I wanted to go back to my friends where they were living at, and I know things that were going on in that neighborhood. And my first night back into an environment that I had moved out of, God had blessed me to move out of, to my first night back into that particular environment, I got robbed.
Okay.
My first night back.
Yeah.
And I was doing good.
Yeah.
But I wanted to prove myself.
Okay.
Why? Because my friends, you want to be accepted.
Help somebody.
And we all, and that's what the enemy does. He gnaw at you. Look at you. Who do you think you are? No, you ought to be thanking the Lord that you move out of one environment and move into the next environment. And I know sometimes people say crime is everywhere, but it's different types of crime too. Let's just be real. Yeah, crime is everywhere, but it's different types of crime. Okay, let me bring it all the way down to you. Certain crime you don't hear in Windermere.
That's right.
Certain crime you don't hear in Owlsworth that you may hear across town or other places. Or other places. And not saying that the neighborhood is bad, but what it is, it's just a lot of people with wrong ulterior motives that's living in those environments.
Amen.
Because I've met some nice people.
Yeah.
Cross town. I've met some nice people in Copper Shore. I've met some nice people in Richmond Heights. I've met some nice people in other. But then it's the governing bodies that control a lot of things that they do in other communities that they ain't out doing in other communities. And then they try to make the community look bad based on what they see, but then we got to dig deeper than that.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do.
How we govern it. How we manage in this community. Why this community looks so beautiful and this community look like you just want to run through it and hurry and get to the other side. Because it's governing bodies. But we can't be so focused on the outer world and the things we have now. And that's what the world want to do. Keep all your attention on stockpiling and bigger, building money and building houses. That's just good. Build your house. Live good. There's nothing wrong. Do it. Please do it. You need to do it. You should do it. But don't allow that to be your sole focus.
All right.
Some people live like heaven got a rollover 401k plan. Heaven don't have a pension plan. Your money ain't gonna roll over there in heaven. I'm talking about, Lord, I like this mansion, but no drapes ain't right. Don't worry about it, Lord. I got my own money. We gonna tighten that up a little bit. No, it don't work that way.
Yeah.
No, you can't add to the mansion God has already given you. And the word mansion don't mean up a many rooms. You can't add to heaven. Talking about, Lord, I like the gates of pearl, but pearl ain't really my thing. That's not me, Lord.
I like that.
That's not me, Lord. Lord, these pictures look good, but 57, I gotta finish this. Isaiah 57, 59 and 7 says this. Their feet run to evil, and they are swift to shed innocent blood. Their thoughts are thoughts of iniquity. Desolation and destruction are their highway. This is how these people maneuver. They thought their feet, their course of direction.
Wow.
Run to evil.
Yes, Lord.
And they are swift to shed innocent blood. Not just in the retrospect of just killing someone, amen, just killing someone ain't had nothing to do with nothing, or killing a baby. In other words, the innocent blood, they quick to make your life miserable.
Yes.
Quick to cause you to be in turmoil. Do you got so many people, murder people with the court system? They call it judicial murder.
Yeah.
So many people have been murdered with the court system, and you say, well, what happened? They didn't have enough money.
To win
in the courtroom.
Yes.
So here they broke. Here their life is in shambles. And this is where the church step in. This is where we have to tell the truth of the matter.
Amen.
Because just because you got rules, that don't mean you're going to live up to them.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying? People violate their own policies and then stand behind them and then try to convince you at the same time. Like you just off the rocker and like you don't have any sense. Like you gave it to the fact. And you got rules, and you read the rule book, and the policy manual says this, but you got some expert walk in, he butt his coat up, and he normally he's an attorney, or he's somebody. See, they have people equipped for certain situations.
Yes, they do.
If they think you very well versed, and they want to get rid of you, or they're going to bring, but they did the same thing with Jesus.
Yes, they do.
Remember when they asked Jesus the question about healing and the Sabbath and the law, keeping the law? What did Jesus say? He said, to love the Lord thy God with all our heart, soul, and mind, and to love the neighbor as thyself. On these two will hang the laws.
And the prophets.
That's how he answered the lawyer.
Yeah.
Believe me, if they come at Jesus, they'll come at you.
Yeah.
And they got experts to deal with you.
Yeah.
If they feel like you're open to shut case, they'll send anybody in. If they feel like you're gonna give them a challenge, he gotta grab his coat, and he's gonna come in, or she's gonna come in. And they're going to try to explain to you in a pretty way of what they think that they got against you or what they're going to do against you. And that's how the enemy works. They work just strategic. And the church ought to be the same way. Why? Because we're made of a body. We're not a place of a business. The church is a body first that conducts business.
Yes.
But we're a body. And the Bible says in the body is what many members.
Yes.
Amen. I pray to God that you've been blessed today.
Amen.
Thanks to God.
Yes.
Stay on the narrow way. Only a solid foundation will be able to withstand.
Amen.
Two courses, but just one way.
Mm.
Many people are going to try to get you to go the other way. Because the other way, you have a lot of shortcuts. It does. To success, to a whole lot of stuff you want to do in life. It's a lot of shortcuts. You can cut the middleman out, cut this one out, cut that out. But then when you get there, you realize there's more to it than what they said.
Yes.
It's just like you ever sign something, and you know they really want to close the deal, and they say, well, all that really means is just, it's just,
yeah.
Mm-hmm. Don't they do it?
Yeah.
Don't they do it? They hurry up. They try to explain, paraphrase it to you. You know, all they really said is just do this and this and this. It's just a disclaimer. You just check right here, sign right. If you want to read it up, there ain't no good way you're going to read 17 pages of that.
That's right.
They already trained in their mind.
Yeah.
They know the average person is not going to read 19 pages.
Yeah.
But then, every now and then, you got somebody who's like, you might as well bring me some coffee. You might as well bring me some coffee because I'm reading all 17 pages. And you should.
Yeah. That's right.
You should.
That's right.
Because there's more to it than what it appears.
Yeah.
And that's what the enemy wants to do. The Bible says, Satan has blinded the minds that you may not see the truth in the light of the gospel.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what the enemy wants to do, keep you blinded in certain aspects of your life that you can't see how to progress in other areas. Not just in spiritual, in your Christian growth, but in finance, in child rearing, in building a family for yourself. Amen, somebody. Because your legacy is not what you leave them, but it's what you leave in them. That's what I want to leave in my kids. It's easy to leave some money. I mean, all I got to do is make sure the insurance policy is good when they die. Amen. Everybody get, you know how you at work, you 30%, 20%. That's easy. That's not hard to do. If you really want to leave them something, just get an insurance policy. It's $100,000, $200,000, whatever you want. And then when you leave and die, you, there they go. $20,000 this, $20,000 that. That's easy.
Yeah.
But the question of the matter is, what are you leaving in them?
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
In them, the foundational things.
All right.
That's going to make their life different. Mm-hmm. That they can be able to survive the onslaughts that they're going to experience. Because we're seeing the things that are happening. I pray that you was blessed today. Amen. Let us stand. Let us stand. I just